Hello, this is Sam from the ecoMaster technical team. And today I'm going to show you in detail the second part of the DIY ecoGlaze estimate and order process. This video will show how to determine how many of the DIY ecoGlaze sets you will need for your windows and how to take the sizes and information that you gathered for your windows and populate that information in the DIY ecoGlaze estimate spreadsheet that has been sent to you. This is the information that you would have gathered as demonstrated in the first DIY ecoGlaze estimate and order instructional video. So if you haven't seen that one, then check it out first and come back here to see the other process. Also, if you don't have this estimator spreadsheet, you can have one sent to you by filling out the contact us form on ecomaster.com.au. So go to the contact, you can fill out your details here, making sure that you select the ecoGlaze DIY secondary glazing and hit submit. Of course, these are the details that we will need you to infill to pop that out. That is going to send you an email that looks a little like this, which you can find your own personal DIY ecoGlaze estimate system right here. Clicking on that link will open up this Google spreadsheet. Now this is a Google-based spreadsheet, which can be accessed online. Not to be confused with a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. They look quite similar, but they operate in slightly different ways. So to ensure that this spreadsheet is working and this estimator is working as it's intended to, be sure to infill your data using your internet browser. The other benefits of using an online spreadsheet is that it saves automatically. So if you accidentally close down your browser or close down your computer, when you re-click that link after opening it again, all your inputted data should still be there. Now we're at this spreadsheet. The first step is to name your windows and individual lights of that window. These are user-defined cells, meaning it could be whatever you like. It's just a way that you can individually identify each individual piece of glass to avoid confusion going forward when you're installing your ecoGlaze. Using the example that Morris set out in the first video, you may name your window something like dining left. And the lights could be called lower left, upper left, upper right. And of course, all four of these lights are part of the same window, so you can copy this one and paste it. Once you've identified each light, you can start entering your measured sizes. So the window that Morris was measuring was 1 meter high and 900 millimeters wide. Of course, all of your measurements should be inputted as millimeters. Next, you need to select what type of system you need for this light, whether it's a fixed light window that doesn't open or close, or it's an awning wind-out window or a casement window, which would use the on-sash system. This light was a fixed one. Finally, you want to pick which moulding finish will best suit your joinery, whether it's the white aluminium or the raw timber option. In this case, raw timber. So you'll see a couple of changes there has just happened. First, you'll get this green identifier, the quantity status cell, which is telling you that the sizes you've entered are suitable for ecoGlaze and the estimator has calculated your sets correctly. If you entered a size that is not suitable for ecoGlaze, usually something that's longer than 2.4 meters, like so, you'll get this as red saying that it hasn't been calculated because it's not possible. The other thing you'll see is the quantity, specifically raw timber fixed quantities, has increased to 2. Now you may notice that the estimator is only asking you for 2 sizes, but of course your window light needs 4 different pieces. The estimator is designed to calculate this for you. So effectively it has doubled your sizes to allow for all 4 sides of your light. In this circumstance, it's calculated 2 2100 millimeter long lengths. The first length would get the left side and the top, and the second length would get the right side and the bottom. Moving on to the next light. Now let's say that this light is a wind-out awning window. And indeed, the window that Morris was demonstrating on in the last video did have this light as an awning window. So that could be 930 millimeters high and 830 millimeters wide. It's an awning system, so we need to use the on sash light type, and again, the raw finish. You'll notice, again, green status, and this time in the on sash in raw timber, the 2100 millimeter long variant, you have a total quantity of 2. So as you continue down adding sizes in, these quantities are going to increase, and that is the total quantity of sets. Now those of you who are eagle-eyed may have noticed that the sizes entered should technically fit on an 1800 millimeter long set, but with the on sash system, the cut sizes are slightly bigger than your measured sizes. And again, the system is calculating that for you. It's about 55 millimeters bigger, which actually pushes it onto that bigger stick. Following this process, we will populate the sizes for the rest of your lights. So you see that's brought the total quantity of sets to 6 for the fixed variant and 2 for the on-sash variant. Now that all of our light sizes are in, we are ready to order. But before I go and show you that process, before I navigate away from this spreadsheet, I want to show you the stick breakdown list, which is everything that's on this side of the green section. So you'll see everything on the right here is in the same names that you have specified earlier. Those have been automatically inputted there for you. And then you'll see the light type that that particular light is, and then moving along how many of the corresponding sets are required for that light. Now, something is only 4 lights, this is pretty straightforward. As you go to add more windows, maybe has more lights, has less, different sizes that will yield different required sets, this can get a bit confusing. So this is a really handy way to break it down and to see what components are required for which piece of glass. You can also print this section for later use. Simply highlight all of the columns, you can go to File, Print. And you want to select selected cells, next, and then it will bring you to a standard printing page that you can use. Okay, back to ordering. To order your ecoGlaze, all of the ordering is done via the ecoMaster web store, which can be accessed through this button and link. So you click on the order now button, and you'll see this link pop up, click on that one, and that will navigate you to the DIY ecoGlaze section of the ecoMaster web store, where you'll find the fixed systems for both of the color variants are under the same product page. You'll see the on-sash system here. You'll see the installation kit, and we'll get into why this is an important thing to add, and also the on-sash fit and finish kit, which is an essential part of an on-sash moulding for awning or casement windows. But starting with the installation kit. The installation kit has several things that make the process of measuring, cutting, and installing ecoGlaze much easier. It puts it all in a handy little package, using these ones for measuring, of course, a cutting jig to help you cut, and some other bits and pieces that are really essential to a successful ecoGlaze install. So it's important that we get one of those added in, clicking on this top link to go back to the main page. Then we can start with the fixed. Now, as we saw from our spreadsheet earlier, we need 6 lengths of the 2100 millimeter option. So we can select raw timber, select 2100 millimeter option, and then up our quantity to 6, and then add to cart. And then, of course, we need our on sash for that awning light, and the process is the same. Select the raw timber finish, 2100 millimeter option, and in that circumstance, we can see the spreadsheet says that we need 2 lengths. We can go ahead and add 2 lengths. Now back to this last option, the DIY ecoGlaze on sash fit and finish kit. Now inside this kit, you'll see that there are 4 end caps to set a trim at the end of your cut for the on-sash mouldings. You've got two supports here, which is what's designed to hold your acrylic up and to help support that weight. A couple of magnetic tools to help you install the acrylic supports, and the screw fixings to install those acrylics. You need to include a fit and finish kit for every lite on sash that you've used. So in this circumstance, we only had the one that used on sash, but if you had more windows or more lights that were using it, you need to include one kit per light. Once everything's in, you can go to the checkout. So we've got the essential installation kit. We have the six mouldings, 2100 long raw timber, and the two mouldings, 2100 long raw timber for the on sash. And of course, the one fit and finish kit for our on sash light. And then you can input your information here and process an order like so. And there you have it. That's how you take the information that you gathered from the last video, how to import it into the DIY ecoGlaze estimate system, and how to take the information from that system and put through an order on our web store. If you've got any other questions about this process, please feel free to reach out to our friendly staff, either at the email sales@ecomaster.com.au, or you can contact us on 1300 326 627. Thanks for watching.